24 on 106.3 Dance Radio. Dance Radio.
Prepare yourself.
Ang silid-aralan sa radyo, hatid namin ay makabagong paraan ng pagtuturo at kaalaman. Mapaumaga, tanghali o hapon man yan, ang istasyong magbibigay impormasyon kahit saan man.
Look for something big.
Alright, here we go.
106.3 Dance Radio. Doña Aurora National High School, Santa Rita, Aurora, Isabela.
This
106.3 DWBR-FM. Pre-calculus, Advanced Algebra, Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry, Elementary Algebra, Geometry. Mga aralin dapat tuklasin. Mathematics Learning Area. Mathematics, kahit saan, kahit kailan. Mathematics, maaasahan inyong tututukan dito sa 106.3 DWDR-FM. Basta Dance Radio, learning is amazing!
Hello! Hello everyone! Happy Thursday afternoon and happy birthday to our dearest chief of Quality Assurance Division of Region 2, Dr. Laila A. Taginod. Kumusta po kayong lahat? How are you doing? Especially to our grade 9 learners. Time check, it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And today is Thursday, March 3, 2022. Ready na ba kayo, our dear grade 9 learners, for our second episode for Shift 1? Welcome to Mata Live sa Facebook Live. And happy listening on Dance Radio 106.3 FM. Yours truly is Teacher Marife Guillermo and siyempre ang aking partner,
Teacher Sunny Bugawisa.
Nakita nyo naman ang aura ni Sir Sunny ngayon, gwapong-gwapo.
Andito pa kasi ako sa loob ng studio eh. Okay, so once again, good afternoon everyone, especially to our grade 9 learners. And our topic for today is all about similar triangles. Ano nga ba ang pagkakaiba ng similar triangles sa congruent triangles? Okay, masasagot yan mamaya sa pamamagitan ng ating mga magagaling na facilitator for today's episode, Teacher Naida Vigilia. Teacher, ay, mga, ako nga pala, Teacher Naida Mangabak, ay Mangabak, Teacher Delma Quaresma, and of course, hindi rin natin makakalimutan ang ating electronic raffle organizer, coordinator, Teacher Marilyn Juliano, and Teacher Marlijan A. Espiritu. Of course, shout out din sa lahat ng ating mga kasama sa Mathematics Learning Area. Magandang hapon sa ating lahat.
Yes.
Okay, back to you, ma'am.
Sir, for your partner information, baka nakalimutan mo si Ma'am Naida, si Teacher Naida ang ating RBI scriptwriter and presentation designer.
Oh yes, of course. Kailangan i-recognize natin.
Yes, sir. Okay.
At syempre, CEO niya ngayon.
Okay. So, special greetings also to our fatherly and hardworking officer in charge, Sir Rodrigo V. Pascua. And of course, to all our head teachers, especially to our supervisory head, Ma'am Merlinda Dayao Dante. To the dance faculty and staff, especially to all teachers of Mathematics Learning Area na nabanggit ni Sir Sunny kanina, good afternoon po sa inyong lahat.
Yes. Good
at syempre, sir, hindi makakompleto ang ating episode or ang ating live streaming kung walang ating mga grade 9 learners.
Tama, kasi sila ang dahilan kung bakit tayo nandito.
Yes, at inaasahan natin na magkakaroon tayo ng 5,000 comments. Kaya ba natin yun, sir, mamaya?
More than that. Target natin more than that.
Yes, no? Okay. So, i-greet natin sila. So, good afternoon to our grade 9 learners. 9 Mendel, 9 Darwin, 9 Pasture, 9 SPJ, 9 SPA, 9 Anonas, 9 Atis, 9 Chico, avocado, lansones, calamansi, dalandan, makopa, mango, guyabano, at gusto ko na ng fruit juice. Happy Thursday afternoon to you, our dear learners.
Nakakalito, ang hirap mag-add ng mga fruits. Last time kasi, ano, nahirapan yung mga student natin doon. Ang sagot pala is
fruit juice.
Fruit salad ba?
Fruit salad, pwede din.
Okay.
Okay. Actually, sir, ang lesson natin ngayon is nasa week 3 po tayo.
Ah, sa week 3
yes.
Na. Ang bilis, ano?
Similar, triangles, pero
yes.
Then next week is Pythagorean theorem.
So paano ba natin malalaman ang similar triangles? Siyempre,
yes.
Ang tatalakayan natin.
Kailangan daw nilang makinig
okay
ng mabuti para masagot at makasali at magipag-participate sa ating matroleta quiz mamaya.
Yan,
okay, tanong kanilang gagawin, sir, para makapag-participate
okay
sila.
Siyempre, huwag niyong kaligtay ang gawin ito, ano? Kailangan gawin niyo itong mechanics natin para makasali kayo doon sa raffle draw natin ng ating ruleta ng kapalaran natin. Kailangan ipadala ang tamang sagot, pangalan, and then yung section sa ating chat box. And then, ibobola natin yan sa ruleta. Yung mga mapalad na sampo, meron lang iisang mananalo. Siyempre, hindi naman na siguro si Christian Dino.
Actually, ang dami
niyang... Okay, pero mayroon pa rin, meron pa rin isang chance.
Yes.
Okay, so ganun. Ulitin ko, ipadala ang tamang sagot, your section and your name dito sa chat box, dito sa Math Alive. Ano ka tuloy? Sa Facebook Live?
Yes, sir. Sa Facebook Live.
Yeah. Okay, so...
Alive na alive.
Ano pang hinihintay natin? Pwede na natin pakinggan ang ating RBI for today.
Oh, before that, sir, magbibigay muna tayo ng tanong para ready na sila mamaya na ibigay ang kanilang sagot.
Yes.
O, oh, diba, sir? Pero bago yan, sir, syempre, hindi natin... wala tayo ngayon dito sa studio at hindi natin may play-play ang ating RBI kung walang ating mga technical specialist. So,
oh,
of course, good afternoon sa ating mga tatlong naggagapuhang technical specialist na sumusunod sa iyo. Don't worry.
Pag nandito ako.
Oo, pag nandito ka, sir. Yes, sila sumusunod sa iyo. Sir
pero
Mark.
Pag nasa bahay ako, mami.
Ay, ikaw. Panghuli ka, sir.
Panghuli
ako. Yes, sir. Malinaw
so,
yun.
Kailangan
araw-araw ka nandito.
Oo, para hindi tayo alis sa number one.
Yes, sir. Sir Mark, Sir Dennis, and of course,
Sir
Joshiel, ang pinaka-guwapo.
Ang pinaka-guwapo.
Oo, sa inyong apat.
Oo, susunod lang ako sa...
Ay, pangalawa pala sa iyo, sir, dahil ikaw ang nauna. Okay, so may we have the first question.
Ano yung unang tanong, ma'am?
Unang tanong?
Yes.
Pakibasa, sir, yung
okay,
unang
so,
tanong.
Okay, so this is now the first question. Makinig kayo mabuti at... magunahan sa pag-send ng tamang sagot. Ito na yung tanong. These are triangles of the same shape but different in size. Okay, ulitin ko ah. These are triangles. Nakikita niyo naman dyan, ang daming triangles dyan. These are triangles of the same shape but different in size. Ano nga ba ito?
Okay, sabi doon sa slide, go, okay. Go, go!
Okay, go, go, go!
Okay, so this time may we have the hearing of the RBI lesson titled Similar Triangles.
Wala nang makakapigil pa. Sulong Arangkada 106.3 Dance Radio sa Aurora, Isabela.
Edukasyon sa sulong. Sana magtulong-tulong. Sulong edukalidad. Dance Radio.
Calculus.
Advanced
Advanced Algebra,
Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry,
Elementary Algebra,
Geometry, mga aralin na dapat tuklasin.
Mathematics Learning Area,
Mathematics, kahit saan, kahit kailan.
Mathematics, maaasahan.
Inyong tututukan dito sa
106.3
Dance Radio.
Learning is amazing!
Good day to our dear listeners, especially to our grade 9 learners. This is your school on the air and it's mathematics time.
Mathematics time.
It is indeed a wonderful day because after all the challenges we've been through, we still have many reasons to smile.
Yahoo!
Make it a habit to tune in to our station 106.3 DWDR FM. Dance Radio.
Radio.
I am your host for today, Teacher Rufino Arpomeda Jr. I hope you are in a comfortable place while listening to your radio. I expect that you have with you your Math 9 Learning Activity Sheets Week 3 together with your paper, pen, and ruler. If not yet, please get them now for you will need them as we proceed to our lesson. If you have questions about your lesson, you may call or message your teacher in Mathematics 9. Here is your radio teacher, Teacher Marley Jane A. Espiritu.
An amazing day, grade 9 learners. I am your radio teacher, Teacher Marley Jane A. Espiritu, and I will be with you for a lesson on similar triangles. Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am!
In today's lesson, we are going to illustrate similarity in triangles. Last episode, we have taken the conditions that make a quadrilateral a parallelogram. Can you still remember them?
Yes, ma'am!
Can you give some of them?
A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if both pairs of opposite sides are congruent, ma'am.
Yes, that's right. Some more?
A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if both pairs of opposite angles are congruent and if pairs of consecutive angles are supplementary, ma'am.
Very good. Any more?
A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if the diagonals bisect each other and if each diagonal divides a parallelogram into two congruent triangles, ma'am.
That's correct. Are there some more?
A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if one pair of opposite sides are congruent and parallel.
Wow! You have remembered them all. Today, we will discuss and illustrate similarities in figures, especially in triangles. Have you ever wondered how we can measure tall structures without using direct measurement? How are sizes of objects enlarged or reduced? How do we determine distances between two places using maps? How do architects and engineers show their clients how their projects would look like even before they are built?
Are all those things possible, ma'am?
Yes, why not? The concept of similarity of objects helps us answer all of those questions related to measurements. How will you determine similar objects? When do we say if two objects are similar?
Two or more objects are similar if they have the same shape but different sizes, ma'am.
Very good. Two or more objects are similar if they have the same shape but different sizes. Let's try your judgment in some examples. You are going to identify if the objects are similar or not. Is it clear, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
That's good! Number one, shoebox and matchbox. Are shoebox and matchbox similar or not? And why? Ready? Go, go, go!
Yes, ma'am! The two are similar because they are both rectangular in shape, ma'am.
Very good. Shoebox and matchbox are similar because they are both rectangular in shape. Number two, basketball and soccer balls. Are basketball and soccer balls similar or not? And why? Ready? Go, go, go!
Yes, ma'am. The two are similar because they are both circular in shape, ma'am.
Magnificent! Basketball and soccer balls are similar because they're both circular in shape. Number three, the alphabet keypads of your cell phones. Are they similar? Are the alphabet keypads of your laptop similar or not? And why? Ready? Go, go, go!
No, ma'am! The alphabetical keypads of my laptop have the same shape and the same size.
You are correct! Wow! Your judgment is correct! The alphabetical keypads of laptop have the same shape and the same size. How about in polygons? When do we say that two polygons are similar?
Two polygons are similar if their corresponding angles are congruent and their corresponding sides are proportional, ma'am.
Magnificent! You really have an advanced reading, dear learners, and I like that. Continue to study very well so that you can participate well in our discussion. Two polygons are similar if their corresponding angles are congruent and their corresponding sides are proportional. When two triangles are similar, the reduced ratio of any two corresponding sides is called the scale factor of the similar triangles.
Ma'am, what is a scale factor?
Very good question. A scale factor is the reduced ratio of any two corresponding sides of similar triangles. A scale factor is used in making plans of buildings and the likes. Can you imagine, dear learners, if engineers and architects use the actual size of the building in making plans? How many drawing papers will they use? That's right! It would cost them much. That is why they use a scale factor in drawing the plans of buildings and infrastructures. Any guess how to use a scale factor?
No, ma'am!
Okay, thank you for being honest, dear learners. If you don't know about a thing, don't pretend that you know because you will not learn from it. Let's take an example on how to use a scale factor in drawing a three-story building which is 20 meters high, 50 meters long, and 10 meters wide. We are going to reduce the measurements by having a ratio. The ratio is 1 millimeter is to 1 meter. So how many millimeters is the height, the length, and the width of the building?
Ma'am, the height is 20 millimeters, the length is 50 millimeters, and the width is 10 millimeters.
Wow! Congratulations! You are right! See the wonder of using a scale factor, dear learners? You can draw the tallest building in a bond paper by scaling it.
Yes, ma'am!
Okay, let's proceed with our lesson about similarity in triangles. If triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, whose scale factor is 2:1, the possible ratios of the corresponding sides are 6/3, 8/4, 10/5. Get your paper, pencil, and ruler and draw two similar triangles with the following measurements. The measure of the sides of triangle ABC are 6 centimeters by 8 centimeters
8 centimeters
by 10 centimeters.
10 centimeters.
While the measures of the sides of triangle DEF are 3 centimeters.
3 centimeters.
By 4 centimeters.
By 4 centimeters.
By 5 centimeters.
By 5 centimeters.
I repeat, you are to draw 2 similar triangles with the following measurements. The measure of the sides of triangle ABC are 6 centimeters by 8 centimeters by 10 centimeters. While the measures of the sides of triangle DEF are 3 centimeters by 4 centimeters by 5 centimeters. Let's pause for a short break as you perform the activity.
Naku! Malapit na ang pasahan ng outputs!
Ah, retrieval time na naman. Narito ang mga dapat mong tandaan sa pagpasa ng outputs mo, Kadonyan.
Tiyaking nakasulat ang iyong pangalan sa bawat subject na iyong ipapasa.
Oops! Huwag ding kalimutang isulat ang iyong seksyon kung saan ka kabilang.
Mahalagang lagyan din ng label na week 1,
week 2, 3, o 4 ang iyong outputs kung anong aralin.
At bilang nito upang malaman ng guro kung kumpleto ang iyong ipinasang outputs sa bawat linggo. Kadonyan!
Maaari, isulat din ang pangalan ng iyong guro sa bawat subject.
Kung may color coding, sundin ito upang madaling malaman ng iyong advisor at maibigay sa tamang guro.
Paghiwalayin ang mga sagutang papel sa bawat subject.
Huwag paghaluin ang iyong mga sagot sa dalawang subject sa iisang papel.
Kung masusunod mo ang mga ito, tiyak ang mga guro ay hindi malilito.
Sa pagpasa ng mga outputs, tiyaking maayos at organisado.
Ayusin ang output batay sa mga sumusunod na bawat aralin.
Una, sagot ng mga gawain. Pangalawa, reflection.
Pangatlo, lingkuhang pagtataya.
At pangapat, summative test kung mayroon.
Isang paalala mula sa pamunuan ng Doña Aurora National High School at ng istasyong ito.
We're back! Are you done with your drawing?
Yes, ma'am!
Very good! Using your drawing, what are the corresponding proportional sides of triangle ABC and triangle DEF?
The corresponding proportional sides of triangle ABC and triangle DEF are AB corresponds to DE, BC corresponds to EF, and CA corresponds to FD.
Brilliant answer! The corresponding proportional sides of triangle ABC and triangle DEF are sides AB corresponds to side DE, side BC corresponds to side EF, and side CA corresponds to side FD. You did it clockwise. How about doing it counterclockwise? Do we mean the same thing, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
Yes, it's the same thing. Just bear in mind that every vertex of a given triangle must also correspond to every vertex of another triangle. Let's move on. What are the corresponding congruent angles of triangle ABC and triangle DEF?
The corresponding congruent angles of triangle ABC and triangle DEF are angle A is congruent to angle D, angle B congruent to angle E, and angle C congruent to angle F, ma'am.
Perfect! The corresponding congruent angles of triangle ABC and triangle DEF are angle A is congruent to angle D, angle B congruent to angle E, and angle C congruent to angle F. The ratio of the corresponding sides of similar triangles are 6 is to 4, 9 is to 6, and 12 is to 8. What is the scale factor? I repeat, what is the scale factor of the 2 similar triangles with the ratio of the corresponding sides? 6 is to 4, 9 is to 6, and 12 is to 8. Ready? Go, go, go!
Ma'am, the scale factor is 3:2.
Very good! How did you do it?
I reduced it to lowest term, ma'am.
Explain it further, please.
Ma'am, 6:4 is divisible by 2, so it becomes 3:2. While 9:6 is divisible by 3, so it also becomes 3:2. And 12:8 is divisible by 4, and it is also 3:2. They have a common ratio, therefore, the scale factor is 3:2.
Wow, magnificent! So, to get the scale factor of similar triangles, you need to reduce its ratio and you will arrive to one common ratio. Can you follow, dear learners?
Yes, ma'am!
I hope so. Are you ready for the next activity?
Yes, ma'am!
Let's have a short break before we have the next activity.
Hello! Good morning!
Good morning, ma'am! I have just finished accomplishing the tasks found in my module. How can I send you my outputs for checking and feedbacking?
Oh, that's a nice question. There are actually three ways for a student like you to submit your outputs. One, it could be via online. That is, if you are capable to connect online. You can just upload your outputs in your Google Classroom or you can take pictures and send them through your group chat or Messenger account.
Ma'am, how about if we do not have internet connection?
If you do not have internet connection, you can submit your accomplished tasks in two ways. One, you can ask your parents to submit your outputs in the designated drop-off center. Two, you can save your outputs if you have available flash drive, CD, or DVD at home and submit it in the designated drop-off center in your respective barangay.
Wow! It's nice to know that there are varied ways on how we can submit our accomplished tasks.
Always remember, for submission of outputs, you can do it via online, offline, or physical submission. Because at dance, we make amazing things possible.
We're back! Let us have another example. Draw two similar triangles, triangle MAT and triangle DOP. In triangle MAT, the length of side MA is 4 cm and side MT is 8 cm. While in triangle DOP, the length of side DO is 2 cm and side DP is X. What is the measure of side DP? Again, find the measure of side DP if in triangle MAT, the length of side MA is 4 cm and side MT is 8 cm. While in triangle DOP, the length of side DO is 2 cm and side DP is X. Ready? Go, go, go! What is the first thing to do, dear learners?
Establish the proportional size of triangle MAT and triangle DOT, that is, MA over DO is equal to MT over DP, ma'am.
Very good! To solve for the measure of side DT, use the proportional size of triangles MAT and DOP, which is AM over OD is equal to MT over DP. What comes next after establishing the proportional sides?
Substitute in the given lengths of the sides in the proportion. So we have 4 over 2 equals 8 over x, ma'am.
That is correct. After substituting the given lengths of the sides in the proportion, how do we solve for the value of x?
Ma'am, to solve the value of x, use cross multiplication. So, 4 times x is equal to 4x, while 2 times 8 is equal to 16. The resulting equation is 2x equals 16. Simplifying it further, divide both sides of the equation by 2. So we have x equals 4 centimeters. Therefore, dt equals 4 centimeters, ma'am.
Ooh, that's great. You're really doing good. Let's pause for some reminders.
Facts about COVID-19. What is COVID-19? COVID-19 is a disease caused by a new strain of coronavirus. What are symptoms of COVID-19? Symptoms can include fever, cough, and shortness of breath. In more severe cases, infection can cause pneumonia or breathing difficulties. How can we prevent COVID-19? To prevent the spread of COVID-19, clean your hand often. Maintain a safe distance. Wear masks when physical distancing is not possible. Don't touch your eyes, nose, or mouth. Cover your nose and mouth with your bent elbow or a tissue when you cough or sneeze. Stay home when you feel unwell. And if you have a fever, cough, and difficulty breathing, seek medical attention. This health advisory is brought to you by World Health Organization, Doña Aurora National High School, and this station.
We're back! Now, let's continue by exploring the examples in your learning activity sheets on page 3. In activity 1, you are going to determine whether the statements are true or false. Number 1, are the given proportional sides 3 is to 5 as 12 is to 20 equal ratios? I repeat, are the given proportional sides 3 is to 5 as 12 is to 20 equal ratios? True or false? Ready? Go, go, go!
True, ma'am!
Why do you say so?
It is true, ma'am, because I applied the law of proportion.
And what is the law of proportion?
The law of proportion is the product of the mean is equal to the product of the extremes, ma'am.
Yes, you are right. And what is the product of the means that is equal to the product of the extremes?
60, ma'am. 3 times 20 equals 60. And 5 times 12 equals 60.
Wow! You're all magnificent, my dear learners. You may continue answering activity 1 after this episode. If you have problems in accomplishing the different activities, you may call, text, or message your teacher in mathematics. Let us pause for some reminders before we have a recap of today's lesson.
Do you encounter problems in accomplishing the different activities in your modules or learning activity sheets? Worry no more, because your teachers are always ready to guide and assist you. You can send your questions or clarifications in two easy ways. 1, call or text, and 2, private message. So easy, right? Remember, at Doña Aurora National High School, we make amazing things possible.
This reminder is brought to you by Doña Aurora National High School and this station.
We're back! Now, let's have a recap of what we have discussed today. When do we say that two things are similar?
If the given figures have the same shape but of different sizes, then the given figures are similar, ma'am.
Very good! To determine whether the given figures are similar, they must have the same shape but of different sizes. How about polygons? When do we say that given polygons are similar?
Two polygons are similar if their corresponding angles are congruent and their corresponding sizes are proportional.
Precisely! Two polygons are similar if their corresponding angles are congruent and their corresponding sizes are proportional. We also use scale factor in determining that two triangles are similar. What is scale factor again, dear learners?
Scale factor is the reduced ratio of any two corresponding sides of similar triangles, ma'am.
That is right. Scale factor is the reduced ratio of any two corresponding sides of similar triangles. Wow, we are done! Thank you, dear learners, for staying with me. Our next episode will focus on the conditions in proving similarity among triangles. You can have an advanced reading so that you can actively participate in our discussion. Once again, this is your teacher on air, Teacher Marley Jane. Have a wonderful day. Always remember that we can make our learning fun and easy if we have a positive mindset that we can do it. God bless and stay safe, everyone. Bye!
Thank you, Teacher Marley Jane. Congratulations, dear learners. Indeed, we have a wonderful day today. If you have questions on how to do the remaining activities, feel free to message or call your teacher in mathematics. Remember to submit your outputs at the designated area in your barangay on or before the scheduled date. You can also submit your outputs through online platforms. On behalf of the production team, we would like to thank our script writer, Teacher Naida V. Mangabat. Our editors and quality assurance team, Teacher Beverline L. Ramirez and Ma'am Merlinda D. Dante, Head Teacher 5 of the Mathematics Learning Area. Our radio teacher, Teacher Marley Jane A. Espiritu. I am your host and your technical specialist, Teacher Rufino R. Pomeda Jr. Goodbye!
Precalculus.
Advanced Algebra.
Intermediate Algebra. Trigonometry.
Elementary Algebra.
Geometry. Mga aralin na dapat tuklasin.
Mathematics Learning Area.
Mathematics. Kahit saan, kahit kailan.
Mathematics, maaasahan.
Inyong tututukan dito sa
106.3
Dance Radio.
Learning is amazing!
Wala nang makakapigil pa. Sulong Arangkada 106.3 Dance Radio sa Aurora, Isabela.
Edukasyon sa sulong, basta na magtulong-tulong. Sulong edukalidad, Dance Radio.
Okay.
Okay, we're back. So siguro naman maliwanag na sa atin kung ano ang similar triangles and congruent triangles. Mga natanggap kasi namin eh, sa marami ang congruent, marami din ang similar.
Yes.
So ngayon, dahil tapos na yung RBI natin, maliwanag na kung ano talaga yung sagot sa ating tanong. Now, this time, may I call on Ma'am Delma Quaresma to share with us the competency of our episode for today. Ma'am Delma.
Hello, hello! Shout out sa aking mga 9 SPJ at 9 SPA. Nakahabol mga anak yung mga sagot ninyo. Anyway, here are our competencies for today. So we have three. First one, illustrate similarity of figures or specifically similarity of triangles. Number two, solving the missing sides of similar triangles. And the last, proves the conditions for similarity of triangles. So make sure na nakatutok kayo para lahat ng competencies na to ay matutunan at maintindihan ninyo. Okay, now, ready na to reveal kung sino yung ating 10 estudyante na nakakuha ng tamang sagot. Back to you, Ma'am Marife and Sir Sunny.
Yes, thank you so much, Teacher Delma. Okay, so meron tayong 10. Unang 10 na nakakuha ng tamang sagot. And sa mga hindi nakaabot ng 10, paki-screenshot pa din yung sagot ninyo and isend ninyo. Kasama yan sa isesend ninyo sa inyong mga teachers. Binibilang din kasi namin yan, mga anak. Okay. So, the answer is similar triangles. And congratulations to Melanie Sagusio of 9 Mendel, Ains Adrian Guya of 9 Mendel, Gerald Fernandez, 9 Atis, Roy Zar Espiritu, 7 Archimedes, grade 7 to ha. Van Dam James Viscara of 9 Avocado, Edessa Monique Santos of 9 Lanzones, Norilyn Ganela of 9 Lanzones, Lovely Jane Fabro of 9 SPJ, Jewel Lacalinao of 9 SPJ, and Maria Eliza Baniked of 9 SPJ. Okay, tatlong 9 SPJ. Spin na natin.
Yes.
And congratulations to
the winner is siyempre from Doña pa rin yan.
Congratulations to
Roysar Espiritu. Oh,
talaga naman ang nag-iisang grade 7. Roysar Espiritu of 7 Archimedes. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Roysar.
Okay. Tignan natin Mana. Kung magpapatuloy ang swerte ni
yes.
Roysar hanggang dulo. Okay. Nakahandang magbigay ng prizes si Ma'am Naida mamaya. Okay. Thank you so much sa ating sponsor, si Ma'am Larna Tan Nevado and Ma'am Naida Mangabat.
Yes.
Okay. So, pangalawang tanong, sir.
Una sa lahat, siyempre gusto kong i-congratulate si sir kasi inaanak ko yan eh.
And sir, kung gagalingan mo pa daw, sabi ng ninong mo sa akin kanina, binulong niya, dadagdagan ko yan. Pag ginalingan pa ni sir, oh.
And, oh, siyempre naman, bakit ba? At saka nagmana pala sa swerte sa raffle sa mama niya.
Yes, oo.
Okay. So ito na yung pangalawang tanong mga anak. Kung gusto niyo maswerte na kagaya ni sir, makinig kayo ng mabuti. Ito ang tanong. Are the following triangles similar? If so, what similarity statement can be made? Name the postulate or theorem used. Okay, maliwanag ah. Are the following triangles similar? If so, what similarity statement can be made? Name the postulate or theorem used. Okay, so ito siya. Tingnan nyo yung teacher dyan. So yan ang ating tanong. So this time, may we go back to our learning facilitator? And for this time, may we have again Ma'am Naida and Ma'am Delma first for the review and the discussion of the illustrating of similar triangles. Ma'am Naida.
Yes, good afternoon to everyone. Thank you, Sir Sunny. So let us have a review on similar triangles. Similar triangles have a symbol, ayun, similar na symbol, parang nakahiga na S. So, ayan, tilde. Ayan. And there are two keywords sa similar triangles. The similar triangles, their corresponding angles are congruent. When we say congruent, they have equal measure. Another is, the corresponding sides are proportional. When we say proportional, they have equal ratio. Kanina sa question number one, marami ang nag-answer ng congruent triangles. Samantalang ang tamang sagot ay similar triangle. Ngayon, i-illustrate ni Ma'am Delma kung ano po ang pagkakaiba ng congruent triangles at similar triangles. Go, 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 Ma'am Delma.
Okay. Thank you, Ma'am Naida. So, para maliwanag sa atin mga anak kung ano nga ba talaga ang ibig sabihin ng similar triangle, so let's consider our picture and illustrations here. Congruent versus similar. So when we say congruent triangles, we'll be considering the first two triangles, ABC and XYZ, with the green and red colors dito na nakikita nyo. So we have triangle ABC is congruent to triangle XYZ. That is, line segment AB is congruent to line segment XY. So nasan ba si AB? AB and XY are congruent. What else? Line segment BC and line segment YZ are also congruent. So we have this side and the other side there, YZ. Next, line segment CA is also congruent to line segment CZ. Ayan, ZX pala, ZX. So AC and ZX yung nasa kabila. So, yung sides nila ay congruent. Ibig sabihin, magkasukat, magkasing sukat. Versus similar. Let's see how similar triangles are being illustrated. With the picture alone, you can see clearly that the sizes of these similar triangles here are different. So, when do we say that the two triangles are similar? So, let's consider triangle PQR, which is similar to triangle MNO. Ay, meron pa pala. Yung angles pa. We have, nga. For triangles, we consider the sides, then the angles. So, balik tayo kay congruent, mga anak, ha? Angle A is congruent to angle X. Yan. Asan yung angle na yun? There. Angle A and angle X, same size. Then we have angle B is congruent to angle Y. Yan. And the last, angle C is congruent to angle Z. So, yung angles niya ay congruent, yung sides niya ay congruent, then the triangles are congruent triangles. Versus similar, yung kabila na. So, yung kabila naman, angle P is congruent to angle M. Nasaan yun? Eto. And yung kabila. Then we have angle Q is congruent to angle N. Ayan. And then we have angle R is congruent to angle O. Yon. So, congruent din yung sides. Kapareho lang, no? So, sa similar, yung angles niya ay congruent. How about the sides? Congruent din ba? For similar triangles, we have line segment PQ and line segment MN or NM. MN dito, you can see clearly that they are not congruent. But, yung ratio niya ay dapat pareho with line segment PQ over line segment MN is congruent. Yung ratio nila, ha, is equal to QR over NO. Eto, eto. Yan, nakita nyo ba yan? QR over NO equal din dapat yung ratio niya, kaya nga meron siyang tinatawag na similarity ratio. Kay, yung other sides naman, RP over OM. So kung ano yung ratio nung unang sides, corresponding sides, dapat pare-pareho yung ratio niya with the other corresponding sides for the triangles to be called similar. So hindi sila magkasing laki, pero meron silang tinatawag na similarity ratio. So dapat equal yung kanilang ratio ng corresponding sides ng similar triangles. And to discuss more on this, meron din tayong note dito. Congruent triangles are similar, but similar triangles are not congruent. Ulitin ko ha. Congruent triangles are similar, but similar triangles are not congruent. Okay. So for more of the discussions, Ma'am Naida will discuss to us the conditions for similarity of triangle. So,
ayan. Ma'am Naida? Yes, thank you, Ma'am Del. Parang naririnig ko, ang dami-dami namang parts na kailangan i-consider. Anim na pares po kasi yung corresponding parts ng similar triangles na i-consider. But there are conditions here for similarity of triangles. We have three conditions. We have SSS similarity theorem, SAS similarity theorem, and AA similarity theorem. When we say SSS similarity theorem, the three corresponding sides of two triangles are proportional to the three corresponding sides of another triangle. So, tatlo lang ang i-consider natin dito. We have here example, triangle ABC and triangle DFE, which are similar. Yan, yung mga corresponding parts lamang niya, ang kailangan, corresponding sides. They are proportional. We have line segment AB over line segment DF, the ratio is 5 over 4, or that is equal to 1.25. Another, we have line segment, the measure of line segment BC over line segment FE is 12 over 9.6, or that is 1.25. And lastly, we have the measure of line segment AC over line segment DE, that is 13 over 10.4, again, equals 1.25. So the ratio are equal. Therefore, we can say that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DFE, according to SSS similarity theorem or side-side-side. Another condition, we have the SAS similarity theorem or side-angle-side. According to this theorem, if an angle of one triangle is congruent to an angle of another triangle, and then the length of the sides including these angles are proportional, then the two triangles are similar. So we have an illustration here. We have triangle ABC and triangle ADE. Ayan, yung nasa loob. Yung line, ayan. Ang galing talaga ng IPO ni Ma'am Delma. Ayan, ayan. So we have for line segment AB over line segment AD, that is 9 over 12. And we have equal to 3/4. Another sides, we have AC, that is 12. And AE, that is 16, 12 over 16, or equal to 3/4. And their included angle is angle A. So angle A of triangle ABC and angle A of triangle ADE is obviously congruent. So we can say that the two triangles are similar according to SAS similarity theorem. Okay. And lastly, we have AA similarity theorem or postulate. When we say AA, we call this angle-angle. AA similarity postulate if two angles of one triangle are congruent to two angles of another triangle, then the two triangles are similar. So we have here triangle BCA and triangle ECD are vertical angles. So we know, my dear learners, that vertical angles are congruent. Ayun, yung may marka, yan. Yan. So the two angles are congruent because they are vertical. And another, we have angle ABC and angle DEC are right angles. And according to the definition of right angles are congruent. So if two angles of one triangle is congruent to two angles of another triangle, the two triangles are similar according to similarity postulate. Okay, so ayan. So hindi kailangang hanapin yung anim. Basta meron lang dalawa according to theorem. So that those are the conditions for similarity of triangles. Back to you, Teacher Marife and Teacher Sunny.
Yes, thank you so much, Teacher Naida. Talagang ang sansapin ni Teacher Naida ng agsasautat tay. Okay. Thank you. Okay. So, ang galing ng ating mga discussants for today. Okay. So, meron tayong 10 ulit. Unang 10. Nakapagbigay ng tamang sagot, Sir Sunny. At mukhang dadami talaga yung ibibigay mo mamaya.
Kaya nga eh.
Nararamdaman mo ba?
Oo, parang may ano, second Christian
Tignan natin kung swerte-hit siya mamaya. Okay. Sige. So, ang sagot ay yes, SSS similarity theorem. Okay.
Akala ko Sir Sunny Sambuchor.
Pwede sir, pwede. Sir Sunny Sambu. Oo.
Oh, joke lang yun.
Alam mo sir, sa susunod na profile mo, ang file name mo na is SSS. May hilo na si mami dyan. Okay, so congratulations to Roy Zar, Espiritu of Seven Archimedes, Lorely Faye Orata of 9SPJ, Hans Galinato of 9SPJ, Jewel Lacalinao of 9SPJ, Ismael Pascual of 9SPJ, Alexia May Duran of 9SPJ, Hazel Joy Balmores of 9 Abocado, Princess Joy Corbito of 9SPJ, Ains Adrian Guya of 9 Mendel, and Katrina May Andres of 9SPJ. Ilan ang 9SPJ dito?
Galing.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Naku, nahiya naman sila sa tatlo. Okay, sige, tignan natin kung sino ang mananalo.
Yes.
Kung may mananalo ba sa 7 SPJ, sir? Tignan natin.
Tignan natin, baka mamalasin.
Okay, tignan natin.
Sabi ko na nga ba?
Okay. Congratulations to
Katrina May Andres of 9 SPJ.
Yes. Congratulations, Katrina May Andres of 9 SPJ. Okay. Yes. Pangatlong tanong na tayo, Sir Sunny.
Okay, nandito na tayo sa pangatlong tanong. May 30% pa rin tayong chance na manalo, no? Okay. Again, here is the question. Sana may mananalo ulit. Solve for X in the figure below. Okay, so we have here angle ABC and angle DEF, wherein line segment AB is 8, line segment BC is 6, and to the second triangle, DE is 12, and EF is X. So you're going to solve for X. Ito yung problema ni ano, Ma'am Delma.
Yes. Hinahanap.
Hinahanap yung mga X.
Yeah.
Okay, go.
Go.
Okay.
9SPJ.
So, ano pang hinihintay ninyo? Gising-gising, 9 Chico, 9 Atis, and 9
Kuya Bano and Mango.
Kuya Bano and Mango. Nasaan na kayo?
Okay, 9SPA.
So, this time, may we hear Ma'am Delma for the application.
Hello! Shout out sa aking mga very, very, very super duper duper active na mga estudyante sa 9SPJ. Super shout out din sa kanilang advisor, si Ma'am Annabel Acupido. Okay, so 9SPA, mga anak, sali din kayo. Masaya, pag, lalo na pag kayo ang nanalo. Anyway, let's apply the things you learn, yung mga diniscuss ni Ma'am Naida kanina. So let's have this triangle here, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle similar. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Si blue is similar to yellow triangle. With, given yung sides natin, AB is 4, BC 7, PQ is X plus 8, while line segment QR is 2X plus 13, and line segment PR is 18. So, ito yung mga hahanapin natin, mga anak, ang makulit na X. Hindi naman siya pabida, pero sadyang kailangan lang talaga nating hanapin ang kanyang value. Di ba? Plus, when we have solved for X already, then we can solve for the length of line or side PQ, side QR, side AC. So meron tayong apat na isosolve. So ready na ba kayong i-apply natin? Dahil sides ang given, yung SSS natin. Sabi ni Ma'am Naida kanina, dapat meron yung similarity factor. So, first we need to solve for X. Ano bang gagamitin natin? Wait lang, is i-black, mag-black muna tayo. Tapos wag disappearing yung ink. Okay naman ang ating pen. Yan. So to solve for X, ang makulit na X, so let's use this. Ito ay corresponding dito. Yan. Ito ay kay 2X plus 13 naman. So we have 4, tama ba? 4 over X plus 8 is equal to, kapag si 7 naman, si 2x plus 13. Yan. Then we cross multiply, parang ang lalaki naman ng sulat ko. So we have 4, multiply natin anak, ito tsaka to. So we have 4, cross multiply natin yan. 4 times 2x plus 13, biglang niliitan eh, is equal to 7 times x plus 8. Yan. Sabagay, pag na-solve natin si X, madali na lang pala yung kasunod. So, next, distribute 4 times 2X plus 13, that would be 8X, 13 times 4, para makamove on daw tayo, kailangan talaga natin si, isolve si X. Then here, 7 times X plus 8, that would be 7X, 7 times 8 is 56. Okay, then ito, lipat natin sa kabila, we will have 8x minus 7x. O yung sign, mga anak, ha? And then we have 56. Lipat natin si 52, so minus 52. 8x minus 7x is equal to x. Ayan, x na lang. 56 minus 52 is equal to 4. So ang value ni x ay 4. Ang daming x. Apat na x. Sige. Because we already have solved for the value of X, anong X lagay natin dito? 4. Okay, pwede na nating isolve si side PQ. Asan ba si side PQ? Eto, X plus 8. Side PQ is X plus 8. So, X plus 8, ang X natin ay 4, so that is 4 plus 8. PQ is 12. Yan. Diba, andali na lang? Then, next, QR. What about side QR? Si QR ay 2X plus 13. So, 2 times 4 plus 13. So, we have 8 plus 13, that is 21. And then, yung last, may last pa ba tayo? AC. Okay, si side AC naman, saan ba natin dito? Kasya naman sa baba. So, 21. AC, anong gagamitin natin? Ilan si AC? Because this is, ayan, 4. Sulat muna natin dito ha. Kung anong gagamitin natin, this is 12. Ano tong PQ natin? 12. Side QR is 21. Okay, label natin dito. This is 12. Para makita nyo mga anak. 2x plus 13 is 21. Okay, 4. Para mas madali nating hanapin si AC kahit hindi na natin tayo mag-solve. 4 naging 12. So, 4 over 12, ano yan? O kaya 12 over 4. Para makuha natin si similarity, ano yan? Similarity as a scale factor. Okay. Tapos, ito naman ay 21 over 7. So, 3. So, kung 18 ito, AC is 12 divided by 4, that's 3. 21 divided by 7 is 3. 18 divided by blank para maging 3. So, ano to? This must be 6. So, AC is equal to 6. So, pare-pareho yung ating scale factor. Okay, so AC is equal to 6. O, nasolve na natin lahat. First triangle is 4, 7, 6. Our second triangle is 12, 21, 18. Because triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. So yan ang ating mga sample for the things you learned a while ago. Yan. Ready na ba tayo sa susunod? Ano ang kasunod ng ating exercises? Ma'am Naida? Yes.
Balik ba kayo, Ma'am i-reveal Naida? Na ang sagot, Ma'am Delma, ng Proleta question para number 3. Balik tayo sa ating mga hosts.
Yes. Yes, thank you
Nine
so
SPJ
much.
9 SPJ ba ulit?
Tingnan natin.
Hindi naman.
Kasi patuloy nating hinahanap si wow. X. At dahil na-solve na natin at nahanapan na natin si X, pwede na tayong mag-move on. Okay. So, congratulations to... Eto na. Meron tayong unang sampo.
Ay, nakikita ulit si Christian.
Christian Vino of 9 Darwin.
Ano pagbabalik?
Tignan natin kung sino ang...
Version 1 yung kasunod, version 2.
Roy Sar
yung
Espiritu. Yes. Of 7 Archimedes. Ismael Pascual of 9SPJ, Hans Galinato of 9SPJ, Romar Fajardo of 9 Calamansi, Maria Elisa Baniked of 9SPJ, Glaisa Ann Salvador of 9SPJ, Jewel Lacanilao of 9SPJ, Hazel Joy Balmores of 9 Abocado, and Joshua Joaquin of 9 Calamansi.
Okay, yung 9SPJ.
Grabe, ang dami. Tignan natin okay, kung sino ang
mananalo.
Naman ang pagbabalik.
Bakit ganyan, Christian?
Ang pagbabalik ni Christian Vino of 9 Darwin.
Christian Vino. Pero yes. Christian, assignment mo ha, si Jeremy, huwag mong pagdrapin yan.
Si Christian Vino, nanalo siya ng 180 pesos yes, load last time. Week.
This time.
Ngayon this naman, for, tignan natin.
First 20 or first 30?
30 pesos ngayon, sir. Sponsored pesos by Ma'am Larna Tan Nevado. At yung kukulangin ay ibibigay ni Ma'am Naida.
Yes. Ma'am Naida.
Yes.
$100. Okay. So what's next, Ma'am? My partner.
Question number 4, sir.
Let's proceed now to the second to the last question. Sa roulette and draw natin. Ito na yung ating tanong. Meron pa tayong 40% chance of winning. Okay. So ito. It is the uniform ratio K of the corresponding proportional sides of similar triangle. I will repeat. It is the uniform ratio K of the corresponding proportional sides of a similar triangle. So what do you call that uniform ratio K? of corresponding sides of similar triangles. And that is our question number 4. Okay, so again, sino na ang mag-discuss ulit? Balik tayo kay Ma'am Naida for the scale factor.
Thank you once again, Teacher Sunny. So ano nga bang scale factor? So this is the meaning of scale factor. It is the uniform ratio of K of the corresponding proportional sides of similar triangles. Below the definition, we have two triangles, a small triangle ABC and a bigger triangle ABC. We can notice that we have the length of the sides on the smaller triangle and the bigger triangle. When we say SF, that is a scale factor enlargement. Enlargement meaning, if the length lumaki siya, then kapag kinuha natin yung ratio, yung nasa numerator niya, yung length ng side ng mas malaking triangle over the length of the side of the smaller triangle. So we have 9 over 3. And that is, the ratio is 3. Another side, we have the bigger side of triangle ABC is 15 over the smaller is 5. Then 15 over 5 is 3. So therefore, we have the same ratio. So that is what we call the scale factor. Okay, so napakadali, ano mga anak? Kanina, naririnig nyo yung, kaninang nag-solve si Teacher Delma. Ay, aba, senior cut ni Teacher Delma. Yun ay yung application ng scale factor. Pag nakita natin yung scale factor, hindi na kailangan yung cross multiplication. Gamitin na lamang ang scale factor. Okay, so that is about scale factor. Teacher Marife, back to you again.
Thank you so much, Teacher Naida. Okay, now let's move on to the application. May we call on once again, Teacher Delma.
Ayan, ako na pala ulit. Sige, apply ulit natin yung natutunan natin. Ano yun? Scale factor. So, paano kukunin yan? Yung scale factor na sample natin kanina is scale factor of enlargement. So, we have bigger over yung smaller triangle natin. So let's try to solve for this problem that we have here. What is the scale factor of the similar triangles? So ano daw yung scale factor natin dito? So since we have two given sides here, pwede nating gamitin alin man dyan sa corresponding side. So if we're going to use this, wait lang, disappearing ata yung nakalagay na ink. So check muna natin if my, hindi naman. My pen is naka-disappearing ink. So, kung ang gagamitin natin ay etong 6 at saka yung 3 sa kabila. Yan, asan na yung pen natin? Yan. 6 and 3, para makuha yung scale factor natin, that is 6 over 3. 6 divided by 3 is equal to 2. Or pwede naman, ano pa, wala na pala. Kasi kung 8 ang gagamitin natin, hindi natin pwedeng gamitin si 5 kasi hindi naman sila corresponding sides. Dapat mga anak, pag kumuha kayo ng scale factor, yung corresponding sides yung kinoconsider natin. Okay, now, dahil alam na natin yung scale factor, yan, doon natin yan. Yan, baka malito kayo kasi nabilugan. Yan, oops. 6 over 3 is 2. Since we already know our scale factor 2, then we can now solve for the value of x ulit, tsaka si y. Minsan napapatanong tayo eh, find the value of x, y. Anyway, since we already know the scale factor, then we can solve for the value of x and y using our scale factor. Oh, gamitin natin ha, andun natin ulit yon para tanggalin yung bilog-bilog na yan. Ang scale factor natin ay 2. So, kung 2 ang scale factor natin, yung bigger side natin ay x, yung smaller ay 5, ang scale factor natin ay 2, without even solving, kaya nyo na dapat malaman or makuha kung ano ang value ni x. And the answer is? Ay, may sagot, 10 daw. Ayan, shout out kay Christian Vino, 10. So if this is 8, yung bigger natin, yung y is smaller with a scale factor of 2, the value of y is? May sumasagot sa comment box natin, no? Y is 16? 16, anak?
Mas maliit yung y.
Mas maliit yung y. O, ingatan natin, ha? Yan. Mas maliit yung y. So, ang y natin
sana kung tama yun, may 4. Bonus yun.
Yan. O, ingatan natin yun na hindi laging nagmumultiply, mga anak. Titingnan natin kung ano ba yung nawawala. Yung bigger triangle ba? Side ng bigger triangle? Or side ng smaller triangle? So, y is not 16. Instead, it's equal to 4 kasi smaller yung side niya.
Teacher Delma, ibig sabihin triangle. Kapag mas maliit yung side na hinahanap, i-divide natin si scale factor.
Yes.
Or kapag mas malaki,
multiplication. Kaya nga, enlargement si scale factor o kaya ano yun? Yung nire-reduce yung size. So yung, siya yung taga-multiply o kaya taga-reduce ng size pero proportion dapat. Okay, so our x is 10, our y is equal to 4. So those are our example problem for scale factor. Back to you. Meron na ba? Kompleto na ba?
Yes. Okay.
Pero?
Meron tayong unang sampo, pero of course, may we listen first to our learning facilitators,
yes.
Teacher Delma and Teacher Naida for the summary of the lesson and application of similar triangles.
Yes, kailangan bago natin i-announce yung ano last winner natin.
Yes, kasi tignan natin, dyan na natin malalaman kung magkano ibibigay ni Sir Sunny.
Ay, ayan. May pa-surprise si Sir Sunny. Okay, so we have learned today about triangles, similar triangles. Triangles are similar when three corresponding angles are congruent and three corresponding sides are proportional. We have also learned that there are conditions for similar triangles. We have the SSS similarity theorem, the SAS similarity theorem, and AA similarity theorem. So, ibig sabihin, not necessary na three corresponding sides and three corresponding angles according to these conditions. And we have also learned about scale factor, which is the uniform ratio K of the corresponding proportional sides of similar triangles. Ayan. So that is what we have learned for today's live streaming, my dear learners. Okay, Teacher Delma?
Yes, and of course, hindi mawawala ang real-life application natin. May gamit itong mga pinag-aralan natin, anak. So here's one example ng real-life application for similar triangles with our illustration here. Ang sexy naman ito, parang pang Miss Universe, di ba? Yan, nakapose. Ay, parang
kasi
hindi naman.
Kasi palapit ng summer. Nagre-ready na siya.
Yes,
na
nararamdaman
siya
ko na nga yung init. Ayan. Ang given dito ay yung height ni Miss Blue. Naka-blue kasi siya ng two-piece. And height ng coconut tree. Parang, so, hindi pa tayo nagbakasyon, no? Parang beach ang gustong sabihin
yes.
Nito. Okay, so ang given na height niya ay 2 meters from yung, bakit ko ba itinuturo ay may pen pala akong hawak? Yung distance nung from that point to the girl is 12 meters. Ang hinahanap natin ay yung height ng coconut or ng palm tree. So paano yan? Meron tayo dapat hanapin dito na similar triangles. Nakikita nyo ba mga anak yung triangle dito? Eto. This one is similar to this triangle here na nagamit yung ating coconut tree. Ayan. So, anong i-apply natin? O, hanapin natin yung corresponding side. So, how do we solve for it? Si height ni Miss Universe, 2, yung distance here, that's 12. Yan. Dapat yung ratio niyan ay pareho lang ng height din ng coconut tree over yung distance from this point hanggang sa puno ng inyog. Ilan yan? 84. Yan. Then, bago tayo mag-multiply mga anak, mas madali kasi kung magsisimplify muna tayo dito. 2 over 12, we can simplify that as 1 over 6. O, para pag nag-multiply tayo, mas maliit na lang. This is 1 times 84, 84, 6, yung height. We divide by 6, height ng coconut tree is equal to 84 divided by 6. Ilan yon? 114 ba? Yan, 14 meters ang ating unit. Hay, nag-ngato. Masyado siyang matangkad na kanyogan. Okay, so this is 14 ba? Tama ba yung pag-ano ko? O 12? Ayan, pa-check po. 84 divided by 6.
Ang tangkad kasi 24. Na dito, 2 meters.
Actually, si Sir Sunny sumasagot dito. Ayan, 14.
Ang tangkad. Tangkad din nung girl, ano? Oh, anong height nyo? 1 point something lang yung height ko. Siya 2 meters.
Pang Miss Universe.
Pang Miss Universe talaga. Oh. Yan yung, ala, ba't dumilim?
Tumilang signal.
Nagsisignal na. O, tapos na kami. So, this is an example of real life application ng ating similar triangle. Na-curious kasi sa height ng tree tsaka height ni Miss Universe.
Dati,
diba?
Dati sumasayaw si Sir Joshua sa likod. Ngayon may pa-dim light siya.
Ginagamitan tayo ng mga ganyan.
Ibang klase naman yung effects na yun.
B, huwag kang ganyan, B. Yan. So, back to you po. I think we're ready with yung ating mga first 10, yes, for
much,
our last
Ma'am
question.
Thank you and Ma'am Delma for your summary and real-life application. Ang tangkad talaga yung dalaga dito eh. Okay, siyempre atat na rin ako malaman kung sino yung mga first 10.
Kung magdadagdag pa siya.
Magdadagdag pa ako, hindi. Okay, ito na sila. Number one pa naman itong inanak ko ngayon. The first one is Royce R. Espiritu of 7 Archimedes. Christian Bino of 9 Darwin, Charmel Ann Ramirez of 9 Lanzones, Romar Pajardo of 9 Calamansi, Alexa May Duran of 9 SPJ, Ismael Duran, ay hindi, Ismael Pascual of 9 SPJ, naalala ko si Sir Duran kasi Ismael, Reginil Bernardo of 9 Chico.
Yes.
Lorely Pay Orate of 9 SPJ. Abigail De La Cruz of 9 Darwin. And Princess Joy Corbito of 9 SPJ.
Napaka-active.
Okay.
Ang 9 SPJ.
Congratulations sa inyong lahat. Okay, de-decide na natin kung sino ang mabibigyan ng 30 peso load. Ready na, Ma'am Marilyn and Ma'am Wardy?
Go, go, go. Ayan, oops.
Wow!
Tuloy-tuloy.
And
wow!
The winner is CV, Christian Bino of 9 Darwin. Congratulations!
Talaga naman, Christian. Congratulations! Sineswerte ka pa din.
Sana yung inanak ko lang. Okay, so that's it.
Yes, congratulations, si Christian Vino.
At ang sagot sa ating tanong, it is the uniform ratio K of the corresponding proportional sides of the similar triangle. I have noted that how many times it was implied in the discussion and the correct answer is the scale factor. Okay, so that is the correct answer.
Yes, congratulations to all the winners. And of course, we would like to thank Ma'am Lorna Tan, our generous benefactor of Matroleta Prizes.
Yes, kung wala siya, wala tayong prize ngayon.
Yes, of course. And syempre, kay Ma'am Naida, mga ba.
Yes. Okay. Okay. Sa celebrities sa ngayon.
Yes, di ba, sir?
Congratulations, Ma'am Naida, for the very excellent presentation.
Yeah, okay. And of course, to our production team.
Siyempre, ang ating technical specialist, Teacher Jocelyn Guillermo. Asan ka na, sir? Teacher Mark Bagamaspad. And Teacher Dennis Yu Mendoza.
Okay, nakita and mo dyan, course, sir, o oh, walang picture, sir, Jocelyn. Pero ang totoo niyan, siya mo ang pinakagwapo dyan.
O kaya nga eh. Kaya nga eh, buti na lang, nabanggit ko yung pangalan niya eh. Mamaya, hindi na lang dark yan. Magiging dark na dark.
Blackout na yan, sir.
At siyempre, hindi natin makalimutan ng ating fatherly officer in charge, Dr. Rodrigo V. Pascua. Good afternoon, sir. Magandang hapon sa'yo.
And siyempre.
And of course, ang ating head teacher 5 of the mathematics department. Wow, impressed naman ako ang bata mo dito. Madam Berlinda D. Dante.
Bumabawi, bumabawi si Sir Sunny. O, oh, diba? Okay. Pang 50, pang 40, 45 si Mami Jaan.
Ang batang-bata talaga.
Yes.
What's and, the secret behind?
Okay, and of course, and special of course, thanks.
Atuloy mo naman.
To our learning facilitator, Sir Sunny.
Yes, of course, number one, ang ating IPBO writer, Ma'am Delma F. Quaresma, our scriptwriter and presentation designer, Teacher Naida B. Vigilia.
Mga bata!
Ayan kasi.
Kailan
ayan kasi Ma'am Maripe, hindi mo binigay yung kwan, bibingka ko. Mali tuloy yung tingin ko. And of course, ang ating mga electronic raffle coordinator, Teacher Marilyn A. Espiritu and Teacher Marilyn M. Juliano. Thank you very much sa inyong apat.
And of course, yours truly is Teacher Maripe Guillermo and
myself, Absalon, Teacher Absalon T. Bugawisan, saying
thank you for joining us and staying with us today. See you again next time on
Mata Live sa Facebook Live!
Bye! Oh, we're just on time for 29. Thank you so much. Stay safe.
Advanced Algebra, Intermediate Algebra, Trigonometry, Elementary Algebra, Geometry, mga aralin dapat tuklasin, Mathematics Learning Area, Mathematics kahit saan, kahit kailan, Mathematics, maaasahan inyong tututukan dito sa 106.3 DWDR-FM. Basta Dance Radio, learning is amazing! Ito ang 106.3 Dance Radio. Dance Radio.
Prepare yourself.
Ang silid-aralan sa radyo, hating namin ay makabagong paraan ng pagtuturo at kalaman. Mapaumaga, tanghali o hapon man yan, ang istasyong magbibigay impormasyon kahit saan man.
Look for something big.
Alright, here we go.
106.3 Dance Radio. Doña Aurora National High School, Santa Rita, Aurora, Isabela.
This
106.3 DWDR-FM.